Hello everyone, how are you? It's Pastor Rod here again from Tokyo, Japan. We're doing a series on The Lord is My Shepherd, the amazing God that we serve and love. He is our shepherd. He wants us to have abundant life. And this week we're going to talk about His great protection in our lives. I've called this message, His presence is my protection. It's also Father's Day, and I believe that God has a special touch on families and fathers and protectors today. And I really believe that God is with us. God is with you. Do you believe that? Come on. He is amazing. I want to talk about the farm, the sheep farm. And last couple of weeks, you might want to go back and have a look at those videos sometime. And it just shows the beautiful sheep farm in New South Wales in Australia, where I went as a little boy year after year after year in September, the September holidays, where there was sheep with beautiful wool and there was lambs and there was rivers flowing and it was green and it was beautiful. And every year we went down there to my cousin James's farm, and he was such a kind farmer. He was a good shepherd. Now Jesus is the good shepherd, but I think the reflection of the sheep farm is a great one for us. And I remember one time we were out there and we saw the beautiful sheep and the lambs, and everything was as it should be, except one day when cousin James said, "There's something wrong. There's something has happened, and there's a predator out there, and that predator is taking sheep, killing sheep, and we're going to have to go on a night hunt to go and find the predator if we can." And this is like in Star Wars, where they said, "Well, there's something wrong in the Force," you know. Sorry about that, but that's my background coming up. But there was a feeling and then a knowledge that there was a predator, a killer of sheep out there. And so I remember as a little boy, we went out in the back of the truck and over the hills, and we found a space where a sheep had been killed. And we were there at night there was a spotlight, and it was pretty scary but pretty exciting, because I was under the protection of my cousin James. I wasn't near the guns, but they had to take out this predator. And I want to tell you that when we talk about a predator, we're talking about something that will kill, that will destroy, that will steal, that will hurt, that will wound, something that is against us. Our predator is the devil. Our predator is the work of the devil, all right? So we're not here to shoot and hurt anything, but we are here to understand that God wants us to learn how to use His strength. His presence is my protection. Now, in my life personally, I actually came to Christ at 19 because God protected me. I was a fireman. I've told this many times, and all those in Lifehouse right now are going, "Oh, wow, not that story again." But it's such a big part of my story, is that I was not a believer. I was a fireman in Sydney, and yet there was somebody that protected me this certain night. It was a big fire. It was a factory fire. It was a fire full of paint thinners and chemicals in an area called Waterloo in Sydney. Big factory fire, and I was there with my two fireman friends with the big hose, and we were pushing together to get strength, and the officer came up and looked at what was happening. We started to hear explosions in the factory, and he said, I'm not happy with that wall in front of you. There's something happening with that wall. There was cracks forming and there was explosions." And he said, if I tell you to run, you have to run." Now, we were three of us firemen together. We were taught in fireman school that you never, ever, ever let go of that hose, because I don't know if you've ever seen a little hose in a yard. If you let it go, it can make that snake movement. Well, a big nozzle could kill somebody. It was a very powerful hose. And so when the officer said, "If I tell you to let it go and run, you better do it," we looked at each other with astonishment and thought, "No, no, no, that's not going to happen." And all of a sudden, the officer said, "I'm going to count to three. One, two, three, run." And we had to let that hose go and ran for our lives. There was explosions. There was bricks flying. We don't know what happened to that nozzle. I'm sure it got trapped by bricks or whatever. But anyway, we were running across the road into a vacant area, into a field. And as we turned around and looked where we'd run from, we were wet from the fire water. from the hose water. We were hot from the flames, but we were unharmed. We didn't have one spot or one bit of singe, no burning, nothing. Me and my two firemen friends. And as I looked across the road, I realized that bricks were everywhere, lying everywhere, and realized somehow we had run through that zone and was untouched. And it was that moment in my brain, I looked up into the sky and there was no one around me at the time. And I said, "Who are you?" And as a non-Christian, I realized that somebody that night had protected me. You know, I remember earlier in my life, I'd been protected. I'd been protected in a surfing injury that could have taken my life. And now this unknown force had protected my life. It took me 6 months after that to find Jesus. And I found that through those 6 months, as reading the New Testament, I realized that God was a protector. I realized that it says in the Bible that He puts angels around us, that He puts protection around us, that God is somehow in control. I realized, even as a non-Christian, as I was coming to know God or coming closer, that I needed to know God in my life. So it was 6 months after that fire, I went to a little church and I said to God, "Now." And the power of God hit my life. The darkness in me left in a moment. The power of God came on me in a moment. And I knew His presence. I knew the presence of the great protector. Hey, I believe in your life. I believe in your family's life. There has been protection. There has been supernatural protection. We may not have known it, but somehow I believe God has intervened, helped, saved, protected, rescued. All these words that reflect the concept that there is a God, I believe His presence is my protection. Well, since becoming a believer, I'd like to say to you that it's all been safe, but it hasn't. I've lived most of my adult life in Asia, and in that time, I've been injured, I've been attacked, someone tried to chase me with a machete, a big knife, I had to run for my life through a marketplace. I could tell you all the things. I've been in jail for a day, jailed, not for doing anything of criminal activity, but anyway, I've got to go on. I want to tell you that God is our protector. Now, this is Father's Day, and I want to bring another picture here. You see, the New Testament picture of God, our protector, comes into the concept of God, our Father. God, our Father, is God, our protector. And I want to say to all you dads out there and maybe single mums and have to protect the children, obviously mums as well, but I want you to know that God is with you. God is helping you to be strong, to be firm, to bring incredible good boundaries to the family and to our person, to children, to adults. We are also called to be protectors. And that's why we need to know God as our protector, that we can protect others. God is our safety, that we can be safe with other people. Do you understand what I'm saying? Amen. Come on, praise God. As a young Christian, I went to church. I found amazing people. And I read the Lord's Prayer, and I guess I'd already read it by this time, but it says this in Matthew 6:13. It says, calling out to God, "Don't bring on us hard testing, but keep us safe from the evil one." And I prayed the Lord's Prayer every day since that moment, something of the Lord's Prayer saying, "God, protect me from hard testing, and God, keep me from the evil one." And as I said, some days were not safe days, but God was always a safe God. And here I am today, and we're going to pray for fathers at the end of this. And if you're a caregiver, we're going to pray for you and believe the strength of God would be in your life. I want to read to you Psalm 23. Here we go. We come into the part of the psalm. Last 2 weeks, we talked about the Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. And then He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. That's the heart of the shepherd for health and abundance, that I'm no longer broken. I may be weak, but now I'm not broken because I have His Spirit and His heart in my heart. I have His... Anyway, that was last week. You can have a look at this week. Is the Lord is my protector. His presence is my protection. Let's have a look at these four things. We're going to read through Psalm 23, verse 3 to 5. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for His name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. And you prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. These are all pictures of protection. There's four of them. You ready? Number one, that there's protection as we are in the tracks of life, the pathways, the little mountain tracks, not the highways of life, but the little pathways that we are all on. And as a young believer, I had to learn how to read the Bible and say, God, speak to me. God, lead me in decisions. Help me. God, be with me. Give me a sense of peace or not peace, and understand guidance. I still am to this day. It's just I've been doing it a lot of years. And I want to tell you that God is guiding you along the right sheep track for your life, the right job, the right partner, if you're single, the right decisions. Whatever it is, I believe God's protection is there if we ask for it. The many sheep tracks of life, and Viv and I were pastoring in Australia for many years, and all of a sudden God gave us a vision of Japan. Well, that was a new sheep track. We weren't ready for, we're off on this track now, Lord. And the thing that Viv wanted to know from God is, are you with us? And so one thing she called out to God is, we felt called to Japan. She said, God, I won't just go if Rod wants me to go, but I will go if you call me to go. And God put in her heart a sense of destiny and power and purpose. And we were able to move our little family across from our beautiful home and with lots of blessings. And we were settled and into a new country, a new situation. The money wasn't there that we needed. It was a place of weakness. We were weak, but He was strong. And in that moment, God provided everything we needed. He provided things as simple as household appliances, a refrigerator, so many things we just received. It was so miraculous. And our boys' education, someone in California contacted us and said, could I pay for your kids' education for 2 years? Yes. God was our protector on the sheep track, on that radical departure. Now, that's not going to happen every day, but I believe we need to live lives of faith. The Bible says the righteous will live by faith. Faith, following God along the sheep track of life. Number two, in the moment, the valley of deep trouble, the valley of despair, or the valley of shadows, or the valley of the shadow of death. These are various translations of a very difficult Hebrew concept, but it really means a valley of the deepest trouble you've ever been through in your life. What is the deepest trouble? As we look back and we think, God, were you there? God, what happened? And I want to say to you, I can't explain what happened and why, but I can say God is with you now, and God can bring healing, and God can bring blessing, and God can bring even ministry out of your heart to other people. That as we know that God is the overall protector, we can move on from difficult moments in our life. I remember once in Thailand, and I was in a difficult moment, and I don't even know if I want to tell the story, but it wasn't anything wrong I'd done, but I knew I was in great danger, and anyway, I just felt the presence of God, and I kept calm. And I kept right, and I made right decisions and came out of that situation. Now, friends, I don't know what dark situation you've been in. It could be health, could be relational, could be financial, could be a lot of things. Could be disappointment, could be heartbreak, could be a loss of a loved one. And this last year, we've had a number of our people lose parents through this pandemic. And it's terrible, but I want to say that God is with you. God is still with you. God is in you. His presence is our protection. Come on, give Him a big praise. If you're going through a moment of great hardship now, let me speak blessing and life and goodness. And God is with you. And if you believe that, you will start to lift in your life. I was talking to a good pastor friend just this week, who had the pandemic, was very, very sick to the point of death. And he said in those days where he really felt he was going to die. At that moment, all he could do was put on the his phone, just a record of healing scriptures. Healing scriptures. You know, God is healing. God is with you. God is for you. And in the darkest moment, all he could hear was those scriptures and his wonderful wife saying to him, "Honey, come on, you've got to believe. Honey, come on, you've got to wake up. Honey, come on, you've got to get up." And the good news is my pastor friend got through that valley of the shadow of death and is alive and is almost completely better now. We're praying for him for complete healing in Jesus' name. But these things do happen. They do. And we need to know his presence is our protection. Number three, in the moments where I need comfort, it says your rod and your staff are with me. The rod is to hit the enemy, to hit the predator, hit the devil, come on, hit the devil. And the rod is to put around our neck to guide us in the right path in the middle of trouble. And one of the things we read in the Bible about shepherds is they had a thing called the sling. Doesn't mention it here, but David had a sling. And David, who became King David, he said, I was a shepherd and I had to kill the bear and I had to kill the lion. It was just part of my job. I just had to do it to save the sheep. And he said, and I will also take out Goliath, who is against God's people. Now, we don't hurt people today, but the thing is that David, as a shepherd, had this sling. And we've got a little bit of a footage here of people throwing a sling. It's not a little thing. It's not a light thing. It's to take out the predators in our life. And we're going to come back to that when we talk about Jesus in just a moment. And the last one, he prepares a feast in front of our enemies. Now, I don't really care if I'm eating in front of my enemies or not. I'm not really thinking about that, but I think it's really important for us to put enemies behind us, bad thoughts, bad dreams, bad experiences, and to eat with joy the things that God has for us today. The shepherd, his protection brings safety, brings joy, brings the ability to eat and sleep well. Wow, the shepherd's presence is my protection, and I will enjoy life. And if it's in front of my enemies, so be it. And I think what that means is we just got to outlive bad situations and outlive people have said things against us and outlive whatever it is. We're not against people. We're not holding unforgiveness, but we're just eating anyway. We're just moving on. So let me talk about Jesus, the Good Shepherd, because his presence is my protection. He came into my life when I was 19. He's never left. The Holy Spirit doesn't leave. He doesn't leave and come even when I sin. He's not too double-minded. He is the Holy Spirit, and he lives in my life. Listen to what Jesus said about the sheep. You ready? Jesus is talking about being the Good Shepherd. John 10:1. Very truly, I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate but climbs in some other way is a thief and a robber. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. Whoa, so many pictures here. But the key one is this thing, the sheep pen. And it's an Old Testament picture of the shepherd getting bits of briar and thorns and making a boundary around the sheep for the night. It's open air. It's not a big structure. It's a small structure. The shepherd has just got bits of briar and thorns and stuff, and he's making this nighttime protection. And he's saying here that this protection is his protection. And he leads us through the gate to the next protection, to the next place. That protection is all around us. And when Jesus speaks about this, he talks about four different types of enemies. I'm not going to go into it. You can read it in John 10. I call it the dangerous world of sheep. The dangerous world of sheep has these four dangers. One, thieves and robbers. Two, strangers' voices, like people trying to draw us into something that's not right. Three, hirelings. These are false leaders who feed only themselves. And four, wolves, who's probably the most dangerous of all. And I want to tell you that Jesus is our protection in all these things about strange doctrine and strange teaching and that strange YouTube thing that took away your joy. And get rid of all that. Come back to the Word of God. Come back to peace. Come back to mission. Come back to future. Amen? Come back. Come back to what God has said to you that you know brings life. And so Jesus gets finally to verse 10 And I'm coming to a close in a minute. I just want to tell you this really incredible scripture. In fact, I would advise you to remember this scripture. Scripture memorization is not popular today, but I think we should bring some back. Well, bring a lot back. But here we go, John 10:10. The thief, this is the devil, the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I, we could put in Jesus there, I, this is Jesus speaking, I have come that they may have life and have it to the full. Have a party life, an abundant life. Oh, hey, the thief is taken away. I'm adding to. The thief is trying to steal. I'm trying to bring. And so we understand that his presence is our protection of love and joy and relationships and goodness. And finally, Jesus says, you know, no one can separate us from his love. John 10, 27-28, Jesus says, my sheep, they listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life. Listen to this. And they shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand. Friend, you are safe in his presence. His presence is my protection. A couple of takeaway scriptures and I'm done. 1 John 3:8, the second part says, the reason the Son of God appeared was to destroy the devil's works. His presence is my protection. 1 John 4:4, my last scripture. You, dear children, are from God and have overcome them. What's them? The enemies. Because the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world. Come on, with his presence is my protection. I've had some crazy, amazing experiences. I could tell you all about how God's angels protected me on two occasions, how I was chased. Someone tried to kill me, but I turned around and was able to preach the gospel in that situation. Or God's presence has been my protection. I want to tell you one last little story. There was a little girl, a lovely little girl who had heard about Jesus. And as she heard about Jesus, she said, he sounds beautiful. He sounds wonderful. Could I have him in my life? And the father said, yes, my daughter, just invite him into your heart. And the little girl, simple faith, just hearing that. And I love our kids program. And we hear of so many tens of young people who are hearing about Jesus and saying, Jesus, come into my life. And this little girl just said, Jesus, come into my life. And there was a scripture that her father told her, which was from Revelation chapter 3, I think verse 17, where it says, Jesus is knocking on the door of your heart. Open your heart and he will come in and eat with you. So she, Jesus, come in and eat with me. Come in, come in. And she felt God's love and God's presence. And she really got strengthened and strong and filled with joy and love. And one of the first things she did was she went to tell her uncle who was far away from God, not a believer. In fact, a very anti-believer. And she said, uncle, I Jesus knocked on the door of my heart and I opened up and now I got Jesus. And the uncle who was not a believer in God was sort of that contempt face and said, oh yeah, well what if the devil knocks on your door? What if the devil knocks on your door? What are you going to do? And the little tiny girl thought about it and she's ding, like a light bulb moment. And she said, if the devil knocks on my door, I'm going to ask Jesus to go and answer it. Come on, come on. His presence is our protection. So as we come to an end and it's Father's Day, and I'm going to pray for every father and every caregiver, every person in authority, I'm going to pray that you would know the protection of God and you would bring the protection of God to others. Amen. Here we go. Lord, I want to thank you for this day, that we remember that your presence is our protection. And I pray every father, every single mom, every caregiver, every person who has authority, I just pray, Lord, that they would know your presence and they would know your protection, that you never leave them. You are with them. You're bringing wisdom and power. And we pray that all those enemies, Lord, you take them out. The devil and all his plans be gone in Jesus' name. And Lord, we would just know you are with us and you love us so much. We thank you for fathers. We thank you for this day. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Come on, give God a big praise. And maybe you'd not want to know the protector like I did. As I said, as a non-believer, it was His protection that drew me to know Him. And maybe there's some of you today saying, you know, I need to know this God who has protected me. Well, you need to know He died on the cross. And 3 days later, He rose again with power. And that cross and resurrection can come into your heart, bring grace and love and forgiveness and a way open to go to heaven, to be with Him forever. Would you like that? I'm going to pray for you right now. I'm going to count to three and say, will you pray with me to receive Jesus? One, God loves you. Two, would you open your heart? And three, let's pray together right now. Jesus, thank you for these people. Come into their life. Love them. Fill them with grace and forgiveness. They are yours, Lord, and you will be their protector from this point forward in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, come on. Come on, let's contact our dads, maybe text or say hi, thinking about you, praying about you. Come on, let's reach out to some amazing people. God bless you.